Hi, welcome to another lecture on SPIROCHETES. Today, I am going to discuss about Determinants of Pathogenesis of Treponema pallidum, its transmission, epidemiology and its immunity. First, Determinants of Pathogenesis. What does it mean? Determinants means factors. Pathos means disease and genesis means origin. So this fancy term basically means factors that help Treponema pallidum to produce disease. So what are those factors? They are mobility. Treponema pallidum is mobile because it has endoflagella. And number two is hyaluronidase. Treponema pallidum releases hyaluronidase. It is an enzyme which breaks down the hyaluronic acid in the ground substance of tissues and enhances the invasiveness of the organism. Treponema pallidum is a human organism. There is no animal reservoir. Treponema pallidum is transmitted through abrasions from spirochete containing lesions of skin and mucous membrane like mouth, anus and genitalia of an infected person to other persons by sexual contact. It can also be transmitted from infected mother to a fetus through the placenta after the first 10 to 15 weeks of pregnancy. Treponema pallidum can't survive outside the body. However, it can survive in the whole blood or plasma for at least 24 hours at 4 degrees Celsius. Therefore, blood for transmissions collected during early syphilis is also infectious. Syphilis occurs worldwide. Its incidence is increasing. There has been a marked increase in incidence of this disease in men who have sex with other men in recent years. If untreated, mortality rate ranges from 8 to 58%. Immunity to syphilis is incomplete. Antibodies to the organism are produced, but they do not stop the progression of disease. Patients with early syphilis who have been treated can contract syphilis again. Patients with late syphilis are relatively resistant to the reinfection. There is no vaccines for syphilis. The outer membrane of Treponema pallidum has too few surface proteins for an antibody to be effective. To sum up, Treponema pallidum is pathogenic because it is motile and it releases hyaluronidase. It is transmitted usually by sexual contact and transplacentally, rarely by blood transmission. Syphilis occurs worldwide and its incidence is increasing. Immunity to syphilis is incomplete and it has no vaccines available. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. If you have any questions or suggestions, please let us know in the comment sections. Don't forget to share this video with your peers. Thank you. Thanks to all.